Greetings, y'all. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade playing some more Farming Simulator 17. We're back at Giants Island, and we've got our plow plan laid out here, I think, pretty much. We're going to cut all those trees and do some plowing here, plow this together, make it a little bit of a larger field where we can. It's going to come all the way back out here to the road, and should be able to increase our yield with that field there, that area there. But here we're on another mission today. I was looking at the map, and I think I did it in a previous episode. We were looking for the smallest field, and I was looking around maybe 6, 7, 8, 21, you know, 20, something like that. But I got to looking a little closer at the map, and if we go down, let me get back to my map here. If we zoom in and we go down right down here, 29, that looks like the smallest field to me. I went and did a mission on it, and it's really tiny, but it's got a lot of acreage with it, and it looks like it's all grass. So that could be something to look at there. We're going to go down and take a look at it. Now, which way do I need to go? Straight south. Straight south on this road. Now this area right here, I probably won't plow that up into a field. I probably won't let us anyway, but even if it did, I'm going to save this one for grass for the animals, for the sheep specifically. So I'm going to keep this one right here, keep it as grass. But this one over here, since it's already got a little field there and it's already planted with something, looks like maybe sugar beets, potatoes. Ugh, don't want potatoes. We may wait on this, but yeah, just to show you guys, this is 29. Not a very big field, but when you look at all the acreage around it, I could grass that in and make this grass field, yes, but that's plenty of grass over there, and there's more on the other side of the sheep, so I really don't think I need this much grass. So I may get 29, plow it up kind of close to the house here, maybe like right here, and leave them a little bit of yardage, you know, there. And just plow this up all the way around here and all the way down here. As far as we can go with it. I mean, this is a lot of acreage here. Still driving, still a lot of acreage. So we could go all the way down to maybe right in here somewhere. And if we really wanted to, we could plow all the way on up there if we wanted to, but we'll stop right in here. I don't think it's actually growing down here. Yeah, it is growing, isn't it? Grass is. So yeah, somewhere right in there, we'll stop and get that, but I want to wait for it to be off of potatoes, because number one, we don't have a potato harvester to do it, and number two, potatoes, nah. So we'll get into potatoes maybe later. Gotta have them french fries and mashed taters. Just out of curiosity, I'm going to take a look here and see who owns this. Mr. George Watson. Now, I've done some missions for him, apparently. So I'm about almost halfway in good favor with him. And look at the cash value, $15,128. This would be a great investment. I mean, it's a cheap field, and we've got a plow that we can plow this thing up with. So, what is that? It's a FERT mission. How much? For $1,000? Nah. We got other stuff to do. Alright, what else we got? Let's take a look at what fields we own. We planted soybeans on the fields that we, the ones that we do own, and I think they're ready to harvest. Need to go look at 17. Well, I can look at it right here, can I? Growth. 17. 17 is still growing, so we're not quite ready to harvest. So you know what that means. That means we're going to start on our logging operation over here. This is what we're working on. This is our project until 17 gets ready. So we'll have some good soybeans. We need to probably run a sailing mission or something there. Alrighty. I'm guessing this is just graphics lag or texture lag. Yeah. I wondered where those trees went that I cut down. They weren't there. So, let me get, Turn this off. Now, this is in no way realistic, but I just want to see if it works. Telehandlers. We've got the Leaper Manitou, the JCB. I don't know about the JCB. It's articulated, so. And then we have the New Holland. The New Holland has been really good for me in the past. I like it. It's a great machine. I've never worked with this Manitou, though. I don't know. It doesn't look like it has a beacon on the top. That one does. It's all about the beacon. I don't know. I've never worked with it before. You know what I could do? I could lease it. How much is a lease on it? It's not that much. I'm going to lease this thing. And then I can always take it back to the store. Here it is. It does have a beacon. All right. I didn't even look at the specs on it. 141 horsepower, 24 miles per hour. What did I say, 141? Yeah, 141, 24, 143, 24. So they're about the same as far as, horsepower and stuff like that. Definitely need to get a log thing here, though. Need a log fork thing there. Yeah, I'll lease that too. Well, no, I'm going to buy that. Because I'm probably going to keep a telehandler. Now, where's it at? Back there in the back. We'll see if this Manitou can do it. Alright. Now, I know this. I'm going to try this. This is in no way realistic. I never claimed for it to be, but I want to see if I can pick up these trees like I did on 15. Because you can pick them up and carry them on 15. We'll find out in just a second. Where's the middle? Looks like it's about right in there, maybe. Okay, close the claw, rotate, pick it up. It totally works. Need to bring that in though, let's see. That's open, that's closed. Retract. All right, let's see where we can carry this, if we can. You know, we could at least get these off the field this way if we wanted to, like, carry them over to a wood chipper on the side of the field. And get on the roads, because they'll definitely be smoother. Get out of these ruts. Wait for traffic. Bet I can't see anything. No, I can see a little bit. Go down this road here. Yeah, it's harder to see. I'm going to jump back out. Now the question is, which way am I going? I don't even know where I'm going, guys. Where can I take this? I can't, I'm guessing over to the shipyard. Grains and roots, wood chips, sea export. I think there's a log sale point over there. It may just not be labeled. Which way is the best way to go? I don't know. Which way is the best way to go? I could get on the road, but there's traffic on the road. Let me see if I can go through the homestead, maybe, or just around it. Yeah, this, like I said, this is in no way realistic, and I know it's, I mean, some people might consider it cheating, but I just want to see if it worked. And so far, so good. Let's see, I'm going to make a left right here, because that's kind of a steep grade right there. I don't want to lose this thing. Oh, I'm messing up his crop. Nope, I'm not. Good. If I can make it over to this road, looks like it's slipping a little bit, doesn't it? Slipping to the right there. You know what? This might work in real life because telehandlers, you know, they got some oomph behind them. Alright, we're back on the road. This thing is shifting like all kinds of wicked crazy, though. Kind of dragging on the ground a little. I may have to reposition here. Gotta watch that traffic, too, though. There you go, get down there. Come on. Oh, here comes a truck. Crap. Close it. Pick it up. And roll with it. Oi! Oh, teeter-totter. Well, I see the physics center of gravity balance is about the same as 15. Oh, nearly. Come to the car. Now can I get through the gate with it? That's the next question. Hoy, this is going to be something. Well, look at that. I made it. Kind of just ran through the brush on that side, but see, it's slipping again, so. And there it goes. Want to pick it back up. So yeah, this might be better just to put them on a trailer and haul them next time. Because you can haul it, you know, with the long axis of the trunk of the tree. Well, I guess I could have picked it up over the gate, huh? Let's see, center of gravity keeps going that way, so let me pick it up maybe a little closer this way. Get down here where I can see. I'm guessing these are just little, like, birch trees, maybe. No, 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 no. I want to grab you right there. Come here. Come on. Cameron. I don't know if that'll work or not. It may not. Or it might work like a charm. Look at that. Now I'll go ahead and retract. And go. So yeah, these smaller birch trees, I guess I just need to pick them up more in the front. Now I think there's a log sale point around here somewhere. I think it's over on this side. I remember seeing it. Yep, there's one right over there. Hopefully they'll let me just drop it in there. And it may make me pick it up. Well, nuts, it looks like it's gonna make me. Wonder if I can maybe bulldoze it in there. If I can get in this way. Ooh. Whoa. Come on. Gotta. Uh-oh, I may be stuck. Nope. Come on now. Get on in there. Hey, there we go. I got $941 for it. I don't care about that, really, but I got rid of the tree. So, yeah, I may get a trailer and a truck and haul that next time. Yeah, that was a lot easier to do on 15, I think. Just pick them up and carry them like that. But kind of want to do things a little somewhat realistic. I'm always a big fan of that, so Yeah, the soybeans are in their last growth stage here, so they should be good to go soon. So, on the way back, I want to look and stop at some fields here. Let's see. Let me go ahead and get my truck and trailer here. Wheel set up. Yeah, let's go ahead and get to wide. Because we can do some logging. Let's get us a truck. Get just a cheap truck. We got Fendt, so let's get a Fendt green. Which one is Fendt green? This one? Hang on. I can tell you which one's Fendt green. That color right there. Remember that color right there. Got a light green and that green. Alright, I got it. Trucks. Light green and that green. That's it right there. So we can match our Fendt truck. Attachers, yeah, we'll go ahead and get back attachers. Yeah, let's get the wide tires. We'll keep the rim color. Gonna buy that. Alright, so we got those at the shop waiting for us back there where we're working. But I want to stop by some fields here. Take a look. See what we got. So I am playing these maps in multiplayer. If you ever want to join me at all, you're watching this and you want to join me, I'll be farming here a lot. So just look for the Grain Arcade. I am on PlayStation 4. I have an Xbox One, but I don't know. There's a big debate about, you know, the whole thing between Xbox One and PS4. I gotta say, I prefer the PS4, I think, a little bit. And it's not just I'm not bashing Xbox. I mean, it's a good console. There's plus and minuses to both, but I don't know. There's just the way the PS4, I mean, you can charge the battery in the controller. You don't have to mess with popping batteries in and out, and that's kind of hard to do sometimes, especially while you're playing. I mean, I have two controllers. Right now, if this controller started to die, I've got another one that's on the charger that's fully charged, ready to go. All I got to do is unplug it, plug this one up, and turn that on, and that's it. Don't have to switch any batteries out. And I'm sure, you know, like rechargeable batteries would be a pretty good investment, especially if you have an Xbox controller, because you have to change the batteries out. And something about the joysticks, the way the joysticks are set up, on the PlayStation, they're even on both sides. The joysticks on the Xbox One controller, it's higher on the left side and lower on the right side, and the D-pad's down below the left joystick. That, to me, I mean, it's off. It's not balanced. And I may sound crazy, but I don't know, it kind of, eventually over time, I mean, that would kind of make you off a little bit, like hurt your thumb, maybe do like a carpal tunnel type thing, just because you're reaching up further. I mean, unless you hold your controller different, which you'd have to turn it at an angle to hold it, but I don't know, I just like the PlayStation better. It's more balanced, so kind of sticking with it for now, until the Xbox Scorpio comes out, at least. I want to see what that's about. So this is field 15, 96,000. He's got soybeans on it, isn't it? Yep. So let's look at 15. 15 is just south of 17. Pretty nice size field. It's right here on the border of 17. If we absolutely wanted to, we could play them together, but I don't know that I'd want to. This is like a main road coming out of there, isn't it? Yeah, it's the East Road. Of course, we could take the North Road if we wanted to, but... Oh, wait a minute. It might have rocks. I didn't check for rocks. There's a rock right there. Boy, they really like their rocks around here, and we can't pick them up and move them. Got a wooded area over here beside it. But if we ever decided to get, 19 here, we could plow 15 and 19 and 21 together. What's 19 planted in? Sugar beets? We don't have a sugar beet harvester. What's this one? Barley? 35,000 for 21. It's a little square field. Run down here to 20 and see how much it is. It's planted in, looks like wheat. $45,000 for it. And I'm not really in good with these guys yet. I need to find the fields that James Harris owns. That's the ones I need to find. That'll be my mission for the next little bit until I come back next time, is to find the ones that James Harris owns. I'm going to try to work his fields and get in good with him, because we need... It'd be nice if field 1 and 3 were his. I guess I'll go up that way and check that out and do some missions for him up there if he's up there. But we need field 12. Where that's our project right now, is field 11 and 12. And we want to work that field as much as we can. So how much did I say 15 was? 96,000. Why is 15 so much more? I guess because this might be a little bit bigger, but... Well, we'll get in good with these guys. We'll do some missions off time. And I thought about doing some recordings while I'm not talking. Maybe doing like in between episodes. Or doing like an episode, what episode would this be, like 7 or 8, something like that. Doing like an 8.1, 8.2, and the episodes in between could be where I'm just working. I don't know. If it sounds like a good idea, let me know. But thought about doing that so y'all could see what I do on the in-between if you'd want to watch it. Basically, I would just be doing missions and... stuff like that, working for the other guys, maybe doing some logging, because this logging's going to take a while. Am I on the right road? I have a feeling I'm not. Nope, I'm not. I need to go back over there. All right, guys, I'll get on the right road eventually here. So we'll see you guys next time. Until then, remember, you reap what you sow. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade. See you guys later.